Assalamu alaikum dear students, today in the online class we discuss the branches of chemistry. Last week we discussed the main branches of chemistry, that is organic chemistry, inorganic chemistry and physical chemistry. So these are the three main branches of chemistry. We revise the main branches of chemistry again in this lecture. The other branches of chemistry are biochemistry, environmental chemistry, industrial chemistry, nuclear chemistry and analytical chemistry. So these are all the eight branches of chemistry, but the main branches of chemistry, they are three: organic, inorganic and physical chemistry. So the organic chemistry is actually the study of hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons are those compounds which contain carbon and hydrogen. There are some other compounds which are derived from the hydrocarbons, and these compounds are known as derivatives. So organic chemistry is defined as the chemistry which is concerned with the study of hydrocarbons and their derivatives. The second branch of chemistry is the inorganic chemistry, and inorganic chemistry is the chemistry which is related with all the elements and compounds except hydrocarbons. So the other elements, that is other than carbon, they are studied in inorganic chemistry. In inorganic chemistry, we study different elements and compounds which are other than hydrocarbons. The third branch of chemistry is the physical chemistry, and it is the relationship between the physical properties of substances and the chemical changes which are occurring in these substances. So actually this is the physical chemistry, which is the relationship between the physical properties of substances, that is the properties which we can observe with the help of five senses. They are the physical properties. The chemical changes which are occurring in these substances, the chemical changes are those changes which are irreversible in nature, and these are the changes in which some new products, they are produced, which are totally different from the reactants. So we have eight branches of chemistry: physical chemistry, organic chemistry, inorganic chemistry, analytical chemistry. So today in the online class we discuss the detail about the analytical chemistry. It is a branch of chemistry which deals with the study of qualitative and quantitative analysis of the substances. The word qualitative means that what kind of substances, what type of substances which are present in any sample, and qualitative means that this is the study which give us some techniques, which give some products, which give us some techniques and processes which we can apply in the lab to determine the quantity and quality of the substances. So the word analytical chemistry is a particular word which is derived from the word analysis. Analysis means to observe something, to determine something. The next branch of chemistry is known as industrial chemistry, and industrial chemistry is the study of the chemical processes which are applied in the industry for the manufacture or for the manufacturing of different industrial products. That is, in our daily life we use some valuable products, that is glass, plastic, pen, pages, copies, and all these products, different types of perfumes, sanitizers, soaps, different types of juice. So these are all the products which we are making in the industries, and the production of one product is different from the production of the other product. So in the industrial chemistry we study different types of processes, different types of techniques which we apply in a particular industry for the manufacture of different types of products. The sixth branch of chemistry is the nuclear chemistry, as the word indicate you that it is the study of the nucleus of the atom. What is an atom? Actually, the atom is the smallest particle of the matter, and actually the atom consists of two main parts. The central part of an atom is known as nucleus, and nucleus consists of protons and neutrons. Similarly, we can see that an atom also consists of electrons. The electrons, they are negatively charged particles which are revolving around the nucleus in fixed circular path, and these paths, they are known as orbits. So nuclear chemistry is actually the study of nucleus of an atom. The protons and neutrons, which are present in the nucleus of an atom, and we are concerned, we are interested to study the changes which are occurring in the nucleus of an atom due to emission or absorption of the radiation. So nuclear chemistry is actually the study of nucleus of an atom, especially radioactive elements. They are very important in nuclear chemistry. After that, we discuss biochemistry, and as the word indicates you, bio, so it is the study of the chemical reactions which are occurring in the living organisms. That is, we know very well that photosynthesis is a process which are taking place in the plant body, and you know very well that carbon dioxide and water react with one another in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. It will produce glucose and oxygen. So the production of the glucose from carbon dioxide and water is a very complex phenomena, and how this reaction take place in the plant body. So this is very important chemical reaction which is taking place in the plant body. As we know that plant is an example of living organisms, so the study of such types of reactions will be considered in biochemistry. Similarly, in the case of living being, there are so many important chemical processes, chemical reactions which are taking place in the human body. So all the reactions which are taking place in the living beings, they are considered as biochemistry. The last branch of chemistry is known as environmental chemistry, as the word indicates you that it is the study of environment. We know very well that we are facing some types of environmental problem in our daily life. So environmental chemistry is the study of all these chemical processes, their bad impact on the environment, and how we can control such things in the environment to protect our life. So these are all the 8 branches of chemistry. You have to learn all these 8 branches of chemistry carefully. Thank you. That's all for today. Allah Hafiz.